I've been here 2 times before, so it's a big honor for me, and especially being the opening film of the platform. Oh, I was totally nervous. It's the first audience who ever sees it, and I was thrilled and overwhelmed, and I think, you know, the standing ovation was just overwhelming. It was so long that I didn't know what to do with myself.
You
know?
No, me neither.
It's a story about after the World War II, and 2 million landmines are still littering the beaches, and basically we force Germans into the beach and to disarm the mines, and a lot of them were just young kids who had nothing to do with the war in itself. So that's what it's basically about.
For me, the story actually, I can relate a lot to this story. I have a past where I came from a dark past and into the light, and that's the same development my character has in this movie. And also for me, the movie is also about that you when you fight monsters, you must be aware that you don't become a monster yourself. And I think Nietzsche said something: when you glance into the abyss glances into you. And I, when Martin gave me the script, I immediately felt like this is my story. I felt I could contribute with something for this movie. And I always like, you know, I gotta watch out what I say now, but I have a hangover, so I can get away with it. No, but often in Hollywood movies, the good guys are all good, and the bad guys are bad. And here we have, because humans are not like that. We all have good and bad sides in us, and I think that's interesting to work with, and that's what I work with in this character. I knew I could play a bad guy because I've done that before and won a prize for it. But the big challenge for me was if I could make empathy in this guy, and if I could make people cry in the end. And obviously it succeeded. I could see that last night. There was a woman, she said, "You made me cry." I said, I'm sorry I made you cry, but I'm happy I touched you.
So it's a hard sell. We've seen so many German war movies, and so that's also why I wanted to make it a little bit more contemporary, if you know what I mean. I wanted to feel like this could be now. The acting should be like we act now. It should be present. It should be character-driven. It should be faces. Shoot it in a non-dusty way. But still have that kind of open landscape, and I'm very much inspired from the Mazur brothers and the whole 60s era of making movies. So, but it is, you know, you just got to make it better.
And I love crazy people, and then he got big balls because I'm not. This is my first leading role. And I know there was a lot of people said don't know Roland can handle this assignment and stuff like that, but he stood on it, and actually there were some of the investors, they pulled out of it, and there was a lot of trouble for him choosing me for this role, because we have a lot of good actors in Denmark, and people, they want a big name for this movie. But Martin, he took a chance, and I think if you want to make something great, you got to take chances. That's when it comes back to you, because if you took like the obvious for the role, then it was like, okay, it was a good movie. But this way, I think we surprised a lot of people. I surprised myself. So
we should all go to the theaters. It's the right place to watch a movie. I know it's become much easier to just lay home and you can put it on pause and go out and have a coffee and go back.
That's what I like. I like to watch it at home.
It's very easy, but I like to just go in there, no phone on, no nothing. Go into the characters. It's a totally different experience you get when there's no pauses, when there's, you know.
I think some movies deserve a big screen, and other movies you can watch on your laptop. So.
You have so little time in actually creating a character in a film compared to TV shows, where you have like ton and a character can develop. You know, I think it's important that you watch movies in theaters.